I'm actually really sad that the program is ending. I have had a really great time here and really appreciated all the discourse between peers and with faculty. People keep asking me if I'm excited that it's all over, and I am excited about the accomplishment of it, I guess, and I'm excited to see sort of the culmination of work that each of my peers has made. It was really wonderful having the milestone of the thesis exhibition, both as a chance to sort of have closure on my time here, and also just to see the amazing work that my classmates have been making.
It's always hard to, think of the edge. Edge can be, I like to keep it loose. Edge to be less clean. But maybe it's sometimes nice to have a more organized look. Sometimes. Usually I like the rough look.
Go.
Oh, hello. I didn't realize that I had company. Please, allow me to make myself at home and you can join. My name's Yvette DeBose, and this is my sweet lambskin rug that my father gave me. And my cardboard fireplace that I made to bring in some of the essences of home. This is where I like to entertain guests and listen to muzak while I work. I have a bag of various blue and pink goodies for a project that I was working on but now don't have to. Oh. Such a pleasure having company, truly.
I looked for you in these mountains, in this tree, and in the sky.
Considered whether, in this moment, you too looked upwards and considered the coming rain. Glimpses of finding you, of sun peeking through storm. Glimpses of what could have been and what could be. But again, the glimpse obscures, and I am once again looking. You in the whisper of trees bound to each other as one, linked as we are linked. I looked for you in the rings of trees, in raised roots webbing together over rocks and earth becoming one. I looked for you in the lines of my hand as I have the lines of the earth, streams and snow and years marking what came and what has yet to come. I looked for you in the lines of my hand as I have the lines of the earth, streams and snow and years marking what came.
Are you preparing the couch? Armchair?
Yeah, in a way. But I'm repairing it with clear plastic, so.
So the wounds are still visible?
Yeah. They are. We're fixing it, right? It's like that little voice in your head that's like, everything's fine, we're gonna fix it. We're gonna make it all okay. Which I think pretty much sums up my whole grad school experience. It's great. It's just great. Everything's going great.
I mean, there are a lot of kind of broken down furniture around you.
You know, I like furniture a lot.
Why?
I think something about domestic space. I grew up in a house that, there was a lot of furniture, and there was also like whole like couches and things that I wasn't allowed to sit on because they were too nice for children.
I got my driver's license today.
Yay!
This is my first ever real driver's license.
That's so amazing. Congratulations.
And I'm 38 years old. I'm very excited about it. I've like been taking pictures of me with it and of it all day long and like sending it to people.
So are these new tobacco plants?
Yeah, these are tobacco plants. These are all my really old tobacco plants. You can see they've gone to seed.
Uh-huh.
So that means they're dying, which is good. They've been alive for a really long time. I've been cutting the flowers and pressing them for maybe some works on paper, and yeah, now I'm growing these new ones.
Mountain Picnic. You can see coming down the ridge in there. Just trying to see how it would come out. It looks pretty muddy.
So it just took.
There's my face!
Wait,
isn't that funny?
Wow.
Yeah. Because I can't control the image, so.
Oh my god.
It blew
how
up me.
Did,
isn't that funny?
So it just took up the image. Like it just like takes the imprint, the plaster.
Yeah, and then I find the remaining transparency really interesting because it also, you know, it's like an image with a negative
right.
pulled out of it.
Yeah, that's so cool.
And that's also powerful in a different way, I guess. Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Ooh. There's a bigger one.
That's amazing. Wow.
Yeah.
Love it.
So you don't get all the individual flowers anymore, but.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Kimberly Volkman, and these are my paintings in my studio at California College of the Arts. This one was in my MFA show, and it's called Rockstar. And then this one right here is called Float, and it was not in my show, but it was one of my most recent works. And then I will show you this painting, which is called Eyelashes, and this was also in my show. And yeah, I've had a really good time at CCA, and I'm excited to see what happens next in my career.
This is my studio. The only problem is my show's up, so there's not a lot of stuff in here. Medium.
Wait,
amount.
Isn't it Tomorrow Is New? I've never seen that one.
No, this was an early failure. Early 2017 failure. It's still on the wall though.
What are you doing with it?
I don't know.
You're not gonna rework it?
No, it needs to be.
I mean,
it's not very exciting right now.
I feel like the experiment you were doing with the fringe is happening here too, where it just like let loose.
Yeah. I think the materials are just too cheap.
Mm.
You can't see past it.
Hi, welcome to my studio. Come on in. My name is Tasia Cipherline. This is my space. Welcome, welcome. This has been my most actual recent work, which are 3D scans of temporary memorials. And then I've been printing them on aluminum. Over here, some watercolors that I've done, just kind of to get me through the Trump era. This is a piece down below here called Topless in California. And I picked up bottle caps from the beaches of California, an hourglass form. This is a piece called Awareness Fatigue, utilizing the awareness ribbon just in plethora, talking about how the abundance of awareness. This is kind of the remnants of a memorial piece that I did, which I'm actually kind of liking, but yeah, so this was the test site and now it's kind of dying here. And then you have my desk and studio area of chaos. I like to call this the dark area.
So I'm recently making a series of drawing called Asian Sisyphus, which is about my grandfather who was a doctor in 1960 to 80 maybe. And it's also about region issue, region news about United Airlines and also an Asian doctor who was enforced to be removed from the airline. So it's like situating myself between the position of that Asian doctor who was also male, and Asian woman and white male person.
Like getting harder as it goes along because it's getting tangled.
Just like hair.
And I've been like trimming it and giving it little cuts.
But now I kind of want to make like a country skirt out of it.
Lift. Walk towards your left. Stop.
When I'm in the studio, I tend to listen to a lot of podcasts versus music. I guess it depends on my mood. Sometimes music is the best, but podcasts, I feel like it's such good time to learn about things. I don't drive very long distances in San Francisco. I really spend the longest spans of time, aside from sleeping, in the studio, so it's the best. And as far as topics go, murder type true crime things are some of my favorites. There is no shortage of true crime podcasts out there, and some of them are better than others. There's one that Clancy got me into called My Favorite Murder, which is listed as a comedy podcast. It's hosted by two comedy writers. But it's a lot of fun, and I recommend it. They're not paying me.
A través de trabajo de carretera sancionado por el gobierno, los Wixárika Huicholes se han visto obligados a cambiar sus preciosas tradiciones en las que tan desesperadamente querían mantener la cuestión de la asimilación y la pervivencia cultural está sucediendo actualmente a los Wixárika Huicholes y se puede ver como un paralelo de lo que está sucediendo entre los Estados Unidos y los nativos americanos. Quiero explorar lo que está sucediendo a estas personas y cómo su arte tradicional se está utilizando como una mercancía no solo para sí mismo, como un medio para sobrevivir, sino como otros no indígenas están tomando sus necesidades y la marca como auténtico.
I remember there was a moment I was like, I made a mistake. Why did I come here? What's happening? Uh-oh, how can I back out of this? And then I stuck it out. And now we're at the end.
The best 2 years of your life.
Oh God. I don't know about that. yeah, just a lot of, I think for me, grad school created more doubt and then solidified things that I was doubtful about in undergrad. But there's other doubts now in my head. I'm just like, shit, I'm dead. But I guess if I could choose to do this all over again, I'd probably do the same damn thing. I just choose to go to grad school, go to CCA. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Rachel Weidinger. I'm working on trying to figure out better ways to talk about and create shared ideas of digital security. I'll give you two quick tips. These are little tiny stickers. You can use them to cover the camera on your phone, for example, or the camera on your laptop. If you're worried about your camera being remotely activated and used to spy on you, you can subvert that pretty quickly with a piece of tape or a produce sticker or whatever. And here is a digital security tip that you should not use. A kind of equivalent of the sticker is that for some hardware, at some point in technology, you could put a dead audio plug in and then your mic couldn't be remotely activated to spy on you from an audio perspective. But now, usually, software is the thing that switches between your headphones and the mic on your phone, so this probably won't work. So there's two quick digital security tips for you. Thank you.
Because I think, I don't know, it's just like, you know, how to create a kind of contingency that can, you know, critique the art system. Also, this kind of contingency is it's also in this system. It's like, use the system, critique the system. This is what I think what is radical. It's like, it's like try to use the weapon they created to get out of this sort of circle and to think about this. And I don't think a radical is a like bad or not good word. I prefer radical because it's really important for the survival of real art.
action.
One of my studio routines is saving paint. I do this pretty much after every painting session that I finish. Basically, I take a piece of plastic, I hoard a lot of plastic, like wrappings and stuff, and I form a sort of bubble around all the paint on the palette, and then I tape down the plastic to the palette with tape that I also reuse and hoard, sort of stick them on the wall for further use. So that way the paint doesn't dry out. I can use it next time. Saves money. Yep, that's about it.
I'm making a granny square right now, so it's gonna look like this.
Uh-huh.
I like to make these when I'm not really sure what else to make.
What's a granny square?
So granny squares are like, they're like little individual units that get attached together and made into like usually blankets.
Mm.
Sometimes though you see really cool hippie ladies wearing sweaters made out of granny squares.
Oh my god.
So I haven't delved into that realm yet, but...
So it sounds very versatile.
Yes, they're like little modular units, and they're pretty quick to make.
Are you going to make different colors?
Yeah, I think so. I have a red one on the wall over there.
Oh, nice. It's
currently inside of a weird hanging sculpture.
Huh. I really enjoy these new ones.
Thank you.
Wow, you've been making really fast.
Yeah, I make fast.
Funny thinking about all the titles for these clips.
Oh, that's kind of interesting.
Richard? 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 Come on, open the door, Richard.
Are you filming?
Yeah. Who's your friend there, Nathan? The whitehead.
Two handsome guys. Has it been a minute yet?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
You can edit it so it doesn't look stupid. I don't know.
Look at these twins. Oh my god, you guys look great.
After graduation, I am going to visit California a little bit because I haven't seen much. Going to LA, I don't know, up and down the coast, maybe to Oregon. And then, yeah, in preparation for probably leaving California, and moving to Portugal, maybe.
Wait, why? That's not part of the plan.
That's part of the plan because I don't want to have 5 jobs to pay $1,000 rent. Consider that a good rent. And yeah, have to live with 10 other people. So, and Portugal, good food, good weather.
Wait, but I thought you liked Brazil.
Well, that's the thing. See, I keep the connection with Brazil by being in Portugal because a lot of the artists in the galleries go back and forth and speak the same language and sort of keep that connection.
So I started collecting stamps from islands that are current colonies. Most of them are related to nature of these places. They document species, botanical species, fauna species, but they're at the same time very violent images. The language of the stamps through also like the imagery, this one for example has a So the Cayman Islands?
Yeah. Do you want to? Yeah. That one's the Cayman. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. You can talk now.
So this one, for example, is a stamp from the Cayman Islands. Mm-hmm. And it includes a picture of, I think that's Queen Elizabeth, I'm not sure, but I just find that incredibly bizarre